Bismillah. We start our center session. First speaker, Dr. Yasir Mir Alam. He is consultant gastroenterology, specialized in inflammatory bowel disease and at Digestive Liver Disease Center, King Abdullah Medical City, Makkah. He completed his internal residency program in King Faisal Specialist Hospital. He had the gastroenterology fellowship training for with 1 year training in advanced inflammatory bowel disease at Manchester University. McMaster University in Canada. He then had 1 year clinical fellowship in medical education at Toronto University, Canada. He speaks about the progressive nature of IBD. Welcome, Dr. Yasir.
Thank you for the ECA and thank you for the AVI for the organizing this meeting. And special thanks for the Dr. Ahmed Al-Ghani because of he's the one who is really working hard for this, arranging this meeting. First of all of us know that the incidence of the inflammatory bowel disease has been increasing all in the global world. And this due to many reasons that we should know about it during this lecture. Most of them is due to the delay of the diagnosis and delay to refer to the specialized doctors. When we come to the history from the ancient years, before the early 18th century, then many diseases had been identified as a gastroenterology cause. And then with the advances of years and progression in 19th century, then the patients, the scientists discovered that a lot of patients, they have a specific disease that's related to the gut. Most of them, it's Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis. And also with the advances of the endoscopies, they allow us to identify these diseases. Bernard Crohn's. It's the first one who discovered Crohn's disease in 1932 when he had an article that said regional ileitis. The patient had a specific symptom that they are different from the other patient, from the other causes that related to the GI. On the other hand, Sir Samuel Wilkes, the one who discovered the ulcerative colitis, and he's from the UK, when there's a debate regarding many patients who is having dysentery, but the specific patient did not respond to the antibiotics. So when the patients had been died, the autopsy had been taken, and with the advances of the histopathology, they identified specific cells that different from the infectious causes. The pathogenesis of the inflammatory bowel disease is very complicated, and many targets and many cytokines have been involved to in this disease. So that's why we had different medication targeting this disease and to have the remission or what you call treat to target at the end. So many cytokines play different roles in inflammatory bowel disease. And also with the advances and over the years, a lot of genes had been implicated in to identify Crohn's and ulcerative colitis. Most of the genes they can share, both can happen and occur in both disease, like JAK2, and some of them are isolated to ulcerative colitis. We have a lot of them, and some have genes have only isolated to Crohn's disease. Most of them is not. Not only this, the scientists and with the researchers, that they've discovered that in Crohn's disease, there are special genes that can cause fistula, fibrostenotic, and can progress the disease to have or complication that lead this patient to have surgery. IBD is not only one cause, it's a multifactorial, autoimmune, genetic, environmental, and luminal can be all together can be identified the cause of IBD. Both of them are chronic and progressive disease, but we can see only the complication and the aggressive nature in Crohn's disease more than ulcerative colitis. Because since the onset of the disease, till the discovery, there is a lot of things that could happen with the ongoing of inflammation. That patient will develop strictures, stenosis, fistula, and surgery. Because till now, all the we don't know the exact definition of the early disease or early definition of the early disease definition of Crohn's disease. This article being published in 2015 by the Laurent and said that at present the definition is clinically endoscopically a biomarker only the early definition for Crohn's disease. And if these patients they don't have a complications like fibrostenotic fistula, this patient still have an early onset of the Crohn's disease. Why I'm telling you this? Because the most that we are late in the diagnosis of Crohn's disease, the more that we have a chances to have a complications. So the early intervention is the most accurate in appropriate matter is what we want. So what is the window of opportunity to intervene before having the complications? So this time, if we manage early, and then we monitor, and then we optimize the therapy, we will not have these complications in the future. So this is what we have if we act early in the treatment. When we early discover Crohn's disease, all these complications, as you see here, will be avoided. We should not ignore ulcerative colitis as well. We know that the Crohn's disease is more aggressive and need more aggressive attention and therapy. Ulcerative colitis is not treated in the early manner and monitored well. A lot of complication, colorectal cancer, and bleeding surgery will occur. That's why emerging therapy has been identified to target different type of cytokines and inflammatory pathways to treat these, to prevent this complication in the future. Since the discovery of 5-ASA, till now with the new era of medications, JAK2 inhibitors, and other, the all works in different ways to prevent this IBD. So what is the goal at the end? We have to reach what we call treat to target. We have to reach clinically free symptom, endoscopic remission, and also biomarker remission. So this is what we have called. My colleague will explain also in about the CALM trial and the treat to target strategies. In brief, treat to target we have in both Crohn's and ulcerative colitis. Both they have clinically free, absence of ulceration in Crohn's, and absence of inflammation and mucosal healing in ulcerative colitis. And also we have to monitor biomarker, the CRP and fecal calprotectin to be a certain limit. Inflammatory bowel disease, it can be out of the gut, what we call an extraintestinal manifestation. It can affect eyes, joints, liver, and the skin as well. 50% of the patient, at least, he should experience one episode of extra-intestinal manifestation, either earlier to the disease discovery or after. So, how to prevent these complications of inflammatory bowel disease? It's easy. So, we identified, or the scientists identified, that there is early red flags to early refer to IBD specialist. In this study, they found that the delay in the diagnosis of Crohn's disease or inflammatory bowel disease, this is the major cause that these incidents and complications had been increased. That's why they created a criteria or the tool. Each one of these items weigh a number. Because what is the most competitive to inflammatory bowel disease or Crohn's? Is the functional disease like irritable bowel syndrome. At least, according to this study, this can be differentiated functional and non-functional causes of GI. So if we have this patient who had more than 8 score in the red flag, this is the red flag that mostly this patient need to diagnose well or to investigate well to diagnose Crohn's disease. Finally, in the take-home message, as you know, the IBD is a chronic progressive disease. It's a multifactorial disease, can affect it outside the gut. The treat-to-target approach is very helpful to prevent further damage and complication in the future and improve the quality of life. The early referral to gastroenterologist or IBD specialist can prevent a disease complication. Thank you.